February 24, 2005, the U.S. Navy and the Missile Defense Agency completed their fifth successful intercept of a ballistic missile target from the sea, paving the way for the upcoming deployment of an Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense engagement capability. The target was launched from the Pacific Missile Range facility on the island of Kauai. The target flew a nominal short-range ballistic missile trajectory, reaching an altitude of over 100 miles and a velocity of over 5,000 miles per hour. A U.S. Navy Aegis cruiser, USS Lake Erie, was positioned off the coast. As the target rose above the horizon, the SPY-1 radar acquired the target and placed it in track. The Aegis BMD weapon system developed the fire control solution, and the crew of the Lake Erie readied the missile for launch.
Eagle away!
Approximately 2 minutes after target launch, USS Lake Erie fired the Standard Missile 3. The missile completed booster burn and separation, followed by second stage rocket motor burn and separation. An airborne camera tracked the missile throughout most of its flight. After second stage separation, the third stage rocket motor ignited, propelling the SM-3 up out of the atmosphere and into space. The velocity, direction, and control were provided by thrust vector control and an attitude control system. After the first pulse of the third stage, the missile pitched over, ejected the nose cone, exposing the SM-3 kinetic warhead, and pitched back toward the target vehicle. According to the plan, the second pulse of the third stage was never fired. This was the first test of a single pulse engagement. The flexibility of the multi-pulse third stage provides a very large engagement battle space against a wide variety of threats. Roughly 30 seconds prior to intercept, the kinetic warhead was ejected. After separation, the kinetic warhead initiated the solid divert and attitude control system. It acquired the target in its field of view and began tracking and divert maneuvers. The kinetic warhead performs a slight coning maneuver to maintain target track. In the final seconds, the coning maneuver stops and the target image grows in the field of view. A direct hit. The kinetic warhead selected and hit the predicted impact point on the target warhead section. This data was downlinked to the ship via missile downlink system and will help to evaluate kill assessment algorithms and techniques. Numerous ground, sea, and air-based platforms observed the intercept. The energy from the impact is calculated to be in excess of 125 megajoules, the equivalent of a 10-ton truck traveling over 600 miles per hour. Also, for the first time, a prototype of the two-color SM-3 Seeker flew on board the WASP aircraft. It tracked the target and post-intercept debris for over 300 seconds, gathering valuable technical data. This was the fifth successful intercept for the Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense Flight Test Program and paves the way for the deployment of an Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense engagement capability later this year. In addition to Lake Erie, an Aegis destroyer, USS Russell, was also on station observing the test. USS Russell was equipped with a prototype Aegis BMD signal processor, which provides real-time discrimination through medium band and synthetic wideband signal processing. Data gathered from USS Russell will reduce risk for Block 06 deployment. A new BMDS element was also gathering data during the test event. The TPS-X radar, a prototype of the forward-based X-band radar, observed the target vehicle and intercept from its location on the island of Kauai. The FTM-04-1 test validated the operational Aegis BMD engagement sequence and demonstrated many critical components and functions, including Aegis BMD 3.0 weapon system, prototype Aegis BMD signal processor, SM-3 Block 1 configuration, and single-pulse third-stage operation. Aegis BMD is already playing a critical role in the ballistic missile defense system architecture. Starting in 2004, several Aegis destroyers were deployed to the Sea of Japan, providing forward-based surveillance and tracking in support of the ground-based mid-course defense system. Last year, the first five SM-3 initial deployment rounds were delivered to the Missile Defense Agency. And in 2005, full functionality will be implemented in the first set of Aegis cruisers, providing engagement capability against short to medium range ballistic missiles. Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense. We deliver.